Hi, my name is Rochelle Matthews from the Office of Information Technology at CU Boulder. In this video, I'll be covering the end of unlimited Google storage and the steps you can take to reduce your storage use. In this video, I'll be covering the changes to Google Workspace for Education, the storage challenge that we face, our strategies to reduce our storage use, tips for how to get started, and of course, some FAQs. So what are these changes all about? Well, in early 2021, Google announced new storage size limits to existing higher education customers. And what that means for us is that by the end of 2022, CU Boulder's new storage limit set by Google will be only 390 terabytes. Today, we are using 10 times that amount. So why is Google doing this? According to Google, their educational offering was intended to be used as a collaboration platform for Google applications like Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides, and so on. Meaning, it was not intended for large-scale storage. Non-Google format files like PDFs, images, videos, and backups take up a lot of space. That being said, CU Boulder and other higher education institutions were never prevented by Google nor discouraged to leverage Google as a storage service prior to this announcement. Needless to say, we have a huge challenge in front of us. As a campus, we have to work together to get our storage use down to 300 terabytes. This will give us room to grow under the 390 terabyte limit as new students come in and work continues. Our new storage limit, set by Google, is considered pooled storage, which means we all, students, faculty, staff, and researchers, have to share 300 terabytes. Each one of us will get a small slice of this pie. So we had to develop some strategies to share our limited storage, and our first strategy was to prioritize teaching and learning. And what that means is that we had to make a major change for alumni and retiree use of Google storage. When this began, alumni and retirees were using 29% of CU Boulder's total Google storage. So OIT is working with alumni and retirees to turn off access to Google Workspace apps, remove their files, and migrate their email to Exchange Online. By 2023, alumni and retirees will be using 0% of CU Boulder's total storage. Another strategy, we're going to implement storage quotas for faculty, staff, students, and researchers. 5 gigabytes per account. Those using Google for collaboration in Docs and Sheets and other applications in Google will likely be well below the 5 gigabyte limit. In fact, our testing has shown that you can have thousands and thousands of Google format files before reaching the quota limit. Another strategy is that we're going to migrate files to Microsoft OneDrive. So if an account is using over 5 gigabytes of storage on Google, OIT will migrate those non-Google format files, like Word docs, PDFs, and videos, over to that person's OneDrive account that already exists today. CU Boulder's instance of Microsoft OneDrive provides 5 terabytes of storage for each user. That is 1,000 times what each of us will get in Google. And OneDrive works on macOS, iPhones, and iPads, as well as Windows devices. I'm an Apple user, and OneDrive has been working seamlessly on all of my devices for the past couple of years. An optional strategy available to researchers is to migrate research data to CU Boulder's PETA library. This service is provided by Research Computing and is available at a subsidized cost. For a consultation, please contact rc-help@colorado.edu. Another one of our strategies is to use Exchange Online for email, because yes, Gmail use counts against CU Boulder's total storage limit set by Google. Here's how that will play out. The incoming fall 2023 students and beyond will begin on Exchange Online. Then, students, faculty, and staff who read their email on Gmail will eventually be migrated. The timeline is still pending for that, but it will not be in 2022. If you'd like to move to Exchange Online sooner than later, contact OIT. In summary, Google Storage was repurposed by Google. They intend it only for collaboration, primarily using their apps. Non-Google files will be moved by OAT to Microsoft OneDrive, and a 5 GB quota will be set. Okay, so here's how you can get started. First, check your quota. I'll demo how to do that in a moment. Second, start cleaning up your files. Look through your Google Drive and delete files you don't want migrated over to OneDrive, or better yet, reduce your storage down beneath 5 GB. Third, keep an eye out for OIT communications. We'll be in touch with you directly if we plan to migrate non-Google format files to OneDrive. And finally, familiarize yourself with OneDrive and start using it today. Here's how to check just how much storage you're using today in your Google Drive, using my own Google Drive as an example. Okay, I've logged into my Google Drive, and I've clicked on the storage button in the left menu at the bottom. It's pulled up this page that shows me my storage use, which is over 5 GB. It breaks down how much is being used in Google Drive, Gmail, and Photos. And then it shows me a list of files that are in order of the biggest size, so I can easily see what is eating into my storage. And you'll notice none of them are Google format files. They're InDesign files, a Photoshop file, and even some videos. Another thing I notice right away is that I have some duplicates that are taking up a lot of space. So I think that I can clean this up really easily and probably get beneath 5 GB. Even if I do that, my personal strategy is going to store those non-Google format files over in OneDrive, because they are departmental files that can be shared within our Office 365 infrastructure. If you want to delete files you no longer want, here's a quick tutorial on how to do so. So here's how to permanently delete your files from Google Drive. First, select your folders or files that you want to delete, and click on the trash can icon in the top right. Then click over in Trash in your menu, select those files again, and click the trash can icon again in the top right. Then select Delete Forever, and your files are now deleted. As I mentioned before, keep an eye out for OIT communications. If we're going to migrate your files to OneDrive, you will receive a message directly from OIT that will include migration information. Also, stay tuned to CU Boulder today for project updates, and check out the OIT website for updates and more information. And here's how to familiarize yourself with OneDrive. The OIT website has a page dedicated to OneDrive. It has instructions tailored for our CU Boulder community. After that, get a deeper dive by checking out LinkedIn Learning. Just search for OneDrive and you'll find all sorts of trainings available, including a thorough overview and some quick tips. Okay, so here are some of the most frequently asked questions we've received. Why won't CU Boulder purchase additional storage so we don't have to downsize? CU Boulder leadership explored our options to purchase more storage for Google Workspace apps and found it was not feasible to do so. First, Google will not offer more than 900 terabytes of storage, which is well below what we are using today. We found that purchasing Google storage would be nothing more than a very expensive stopgap and is not a viable long-term solution for CU Boulder storage needs. Like many of our public R1 peers, we believe that working to migrate data off the platform before the storage limit is imposed is the most prudent option. Can I use research or departmental funds to purchase Google storage? Google Workspace for Education is a product provided at the campus level. There is no mechanism for individual units or departments to purchase storage from Google directly, or for CU Boulder to allocate custom quotas of storage to individual units or departments. Can I still use Google Workspace apps for collaboration? Yes, absolutely. Google Workspace apps will still be available to students, faculty, staff, and researchers. The quota will be in place, but like I mentioned before, you can have thousands and thousands of Google format files without reaching your quota. What will the migration of non-Google files be like? OIT is still working out the technical implementation details, but what I can tell you is that if your Google Drive is over 5 GB, We will communicate with you and let you know when you can expect your files to be moved over to your account in Microsoft OneDrive. What if the solutions you've outlined don't meet my specialized needs? The solutions we outlined will work for almost everyone, but if you have truly unique use case and would like to get a consult from OIT, visit oit.colorado.edu/google-storage-limits and look for the link to set up a consult appointment. For more FAQs and information, visit oit.colorado.edu/google-storage-limits. And thanks to you. We know this is a less than ideal situation, but it's going to take our work together as a community to meet these new storage limits, and we appreciate your help.